Variable valve timing has been around for quite a while. You may have heard of Toyota's VVT-i, or if you've been in the car scene for a while, you've probably heard of VTEC. Yes, I'm talking about the one where they say, VTEC just kicked in, yo. But what actually is variable valve timing? How does it work? And what is the purpose of this?
We got history, got me feeling the nostalgia when you look at me.
Picture an engine at about 20 to 30 RPMs. Now this isn't actually possible, but just pretend it is. So the camshaft, not to be mistaken with the crankshaft, has lobes that push on valve springs. The camshaft controls the valve springs to let air in and out at the right time, via the intake and exhaust valves. Ideally, the intake valve should open exactly when the piston is at top dead center of the first stroke and close at the bottom dead center. Of course, the exhaust valves would ideally also open at the bottom dead center of the fourth stroke and close at the top dead center of the fourth stroke. However, at normal engine speeds, especially at higher revs, the piston can't suck that much air into the chamber because at several thousand RPMs, the valves are opening and closing several times a second and reach more than 50 times a second. Here's a clip of a BMW S1000RR engine, a 193 horsepower superbike that can rev up to 14,000 RPMs. You can see here that the camshaft and valves are moving at over 100 cycles per second. So how did manufacturers deal with this problem? They changed the timing or the height of the camshaft, of course. Now VTEC stands for Variable Valve Timing and Lift Electronic Control, which frankly is a mouthful to say. VTEC varies when it engages, but usually around 4 to 5,000 RPM. In VTEC engines, there are two sets of lobes, a smaller one when the engine doesn't necessarily need to make a lot of power, and a bigger set when you floor the engine. The other popular form of VVT is in Toyota's VVT-i system, which stands for Variable Valve Timing with Intelligence. VVT-i was first introduced in the 1JZ and the 2JZ GTE, which we obviously know what it's famous for. The difference between VTEC and VVT-i is that VVT-i can't actually change the lift of the valves, but it changes the timing of the camshaft from the camshaft drive. Both are powered by the engine's oil pressure and both have an improvement in performance, whether it is in efficiency or in power. So that was variable valve timing explained in about 3 minutes. Once again, if you enjoyed the video or thought it was helpful or informative, please consider leaving a like or even subscribing if you're really interested in my content. I have 2 other videos so far uploaded on this channel. One is about the Mazda Miata, and the other video is about the Honda S-Line series, starting from the S360 back in 1950s all the way to the Honda S660, which is a Honda sports car you may have never known about, so feel free to check those videos out. I apologize for the fact that this video is so short, but I just don't have time since I have to be preparing for school very soon. Other than that, thanks for watching.